मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट एंड वेलकम टू संताजी वन एंड मेकर। आई एम इंग्लिश टीचर मिस्टर महादेव भावरे। आई टीच टुडे टू सेवन स्टैंडर्ड। माय बुक ऑफ ग्रामर एंड कंपोजिशन। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग टू आवर टीचिंग, डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब आवर यूट्यूब चैनल संताजी वन एंड मेकर एंड प्रेस बेल बटन। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे we are going to learn lesson number 3, clauses. So here, what is the in a previous period we had learned what is mean by phrase, and in this lesson we are going to learn about the clause. Phrase, it means the group of word which have little sense. And what is mean by clause? Clause, it means the group of word and part of sentence which have indicate its meaning or which can't indicate its meaning. That part of sentence is known as clause. Here, read these sentences. The man who is at the door is my brother. We rested when the clock struck one. Wait here until I return. He does not know why he was called to the office. The sun rises in the east and sets in the west. The highlighted group of words in the sentences are called clause. Each of the clauses has subject and a finite verb or main verb. So here, a group of word that is a part of sentence make a complete sense has subject and finite verb is called a clause. Here, what is mean by clause? A group of word that is a part of sentence. Group of word and that is part of sentence make complete sense has a subject and a finite verb is called a clause. Here, clause can be dependent or independent. It means main clause and subordinating clause. Main clause, it means independent clause, and subordinating clause, it means dependent clause. Look at the table showing dependent and independent clause. Here, independent main clause, the man is my brother. Clause marker, connector, who, the man is at the door. We rested when the clock struck one. Wait here until I return. He does not know why he called to the office. The sun rises in the east and the sun sets in the west. A clause that can stand on its own in a sentence is called a main clause. A clause that can stand on its own in a sentence is called a main clause or independent clause. A clause that depends on the main clause to complete the sentence is called a subordinating clause or a dependent clause. Here it means in simple language we can say that what is my main clause? The main clause, the clause, the group of word which can indicate its meaning, or the group of word and part of sentence which can indicate its meaning, or it has a include a subject, verb, object. That clause is known as main clause. And what is mean by subordinating clause? Subordinating clause, it means the group of word and part of sentence which can't indicate its meaning itself. If it want to indicate its meaning, it will be fully dependent on main clause to indicate the meaning. So here, the clause markers or connectors are conjunctions. The clause markers or connectors आर कंजक्शन कोऑर्डिनेट कंजक्शन आर यूज टू लिंक इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉजेस सबऑर्डिनेटिंग कंजक्शंस आर यूज टू लिंक डिपेंडेंट क्लॉजेस टू द मेन क्लॉज हियर रीड दिस सेंटेंसेस आई डू नॉट नो वॉट यू लाइक ही आस्क मी वेयर यू ट्रेन वेयर द ट्रेन वुड अराइव ही आस्क हु आई वॉन्टेड टू सी ही वॉन्टेड टू नो हुम आई वुड प्रिफर दे वेयर क्यूरियस टू नो वेयर आई लिव्ड इट इज अ मिस्ट्री वॉट ही हैज सर्वाइव्ड गिव हिम वॉट एवर ही आस्क फॉर द हाईलाइटेड क्लॉज आर नो नाउन क्लॉजेस एज दे फंक्शन एज नाउन द क्लॉज कनेक्टेड इन द सेंटेंस आर वॉट वेन हुम वेयर दैट एंड वॉट एवर A noun clause answers the question who and what to the verb in the sentence. The clause in the sentence that function as a noun is called a noun clause. So the clause which function as a noun in the sentence, that clause is known as noun clause. So we stop here today. Thank you.